3 million people have watched an online video called Fat Girl Dancing. It's not a nasty viral attack, but it is a celebration and it's changed the life of a woman who stars in it. Now, before we meet her, let's take a look.
Jason Derulo.
Get jazzy on it. That flat bet to get on. International. First class seat on my lap, girl. Riding comfortable. Oh, yeah. Cause I know what the girl them need. New York to Haiti. I got a lipstick stamp for my passport. I make it hard to leave. Been around the world, don't speak the language. But your booty don't need explaining. All I really need to understand is when you talk dirty to me.
Radio producer Whitney Thor, who you just saw owning those dance moves. She joins us live from Charlotte, North Carolina. Whitney, girl, you can move. Oh.
Thank you. I was just saying to you, though, in the ad break that I was a bit loath to intro it as Fat Girl Dancing. Is that something that you named the clip?
Yes, I actually named it that at the suggestion of my coworker, but I certainly own that name, and I think it's important to juxtapose the word fat with some positive things, because so often we think that fat means stupid, lazy, ugly, worthless, and that's how I felt for almost 10 years when I was fat. And then I realized that I'm not any of those things, and I do have contributions and talents, and so I think absolutely I don't want to take attention away from the fact that I'm fat. I absolutely want to put attention on it and show that I'm fat and a lot of other really good things too.
Good on you, Whitney.
Fantastic. And have you been surprised by the response from people?
Yes, yes, especially you Aussies. You're very, very supportive, especially on the internet. Almost every day I get new messages from Australia. I love it. I can't believe, really, the amount of support and also the fact that my story is not unique. And in a way, that kind of makes me sad because I hear from women and men all over the world talking about their experiences with shame and even specifically with polycystic ovarian syndrome, which is the health condition that I have that caused a lot of the weight gain. And it's just incredible to me to be able to connect with so many people. And like I said, it's kind of sad that so many people have the same story, but in a way, it's nice because we can all support each other and feel better about ourselves because there's strength in numbers, for sure.
Absolutely. Whitney, I'm fascinated about the process that you've gone through. You skipped over it very quickly when you said, you know, you went through all this shaming and lack of self-worth, and then you realised that you not only were you fat, but you were all these great things. So I wanted to, right. I want you to tell me a little bit about that process, because that can't have been just a sudden realisation, a light switch going off.
No, yeah. Well, I gained almost 200 pounds 10 years ago, and I gained it very quickly because of polycystic ovarian syndrome. So immediately, I totally quit my life. I almost failed out of college. I quit dancing. I felt horrible about myself, which is kind of interesting because I kind of didn't feel great about myself to begin with, just because I'm a young woman, you know, growing up in the West where we have so many expectations put on us. But I suffered a lot for 10 years, and I lived in Korea for 4 years, which is a whole different ballgame in the body image arena, for sure, and it was really difficult. And then when I came back to the States, I actually lost 100 pounds in 8 months. It was the hardest thing I ever did, and I've gained it back now, so don't anybody get too excited about that. But I realized that at that time, I thought I should have been a lot happier, but all I could obsess about was, when am I going to lose the next 100 so that I won't be fat anymore? And even though I could run 5 miles and I became a licensed Zumba instructor, I was still obsessed with not being called fat, even though I was fit and healthy and happy, and I should have really been satisfied, but I wasn't. And then I started working for a radio station, and I started gaining weight back, but I actually kind of became a spokesperson almost for big women, and not on purpose, but just because I was giving them a voice. And I found that I self-actualized because I had to talk about my weight every day. I had to you know, field questions and defend myself and you know, listen to the fat jokes and all those kinds of things. And so I really had to figure out very quickly how I felt about myself.
Whitney, if I can interrupt you, you know, being in the radio, yes. You'll understand we've always have time constraints in television as well. Yeah. You'd understand that working in radio. Just finally, I mean, you're very positive, and I can see that that's a good message to give to other people who are big girls like you are. But what myths do you hope to dispel about overweight people? I mean, what is your message to the entire community?
Right, I want people to know that just because you're fat, it doesn't mean that you're worthless. There are a million things that you can still do while you're fat, and I want people who are fat to realize that they can get up and be active if they want to. They can dance, they can do whatever they want, and it doesn't have to limit them. And I just know that I lived that way for almost a decade, and I'm really sad that I missed out on a lot of my life, and now I'm finally living, and I just want other people to do the same.
Woohoo! Not just living, you are owning that dance floor, girlfriend. Wow. Whitney Thor, what an inspiration you are. Thank you so much for joining
Thank
us.
You.
What a lovely
Thank
girl.
You for having yeah. me.
And you can check out more of Whitney's great advice at nobodyshamecampaign.com. All right, Craig Bennett is standing by with today's Showbiz File. The music's up. Craig, deliver.
Just call me Bad Penny, I am back. You're copping a double blast of showbiz goss today. You are gossip gluttons, aren't you? Anyway, Patrick Swayze's widow, she weds. I have all the really lovely details of that. Nicole Kidman, George Clooney, Jane Fonda at 76. Everybody's saying, how does she look so figure fab? You will not believe her secret. Well, it won't be a secret anymore, will it? Look, all of that is coming very soon. Studio 10 is taking a break. We'll be back and you cop all the goss.